Sup, you beautiful people. Hope you've had a fantastic day. Welcome back to another new episode of What If Naruto Has a Demonic Heritage. If you guys enjoyed this what if, comment down below and let me know. And go ahead and check out other what ifs in the channel after watching this video. Don't forget to shower some appreciation onto the incredible author responsible for this fanfiction. The link is conveniently waiting for you in the description down below. Before we get into it though, don't forget to subscribe and leave a like. And also share this video with your friends. So let's start this video. Kairi. Naruto looked around searching for the woman that looked so much like Kairi. He had been following the faint glimpses of her, but now he seemed to have lost her trail. The battle with Echidna had taken its toll. He was covered in cuts and bruises, his nearly instantaneous healing having slowed down to human levels. The only items he had left from being blasted through the forest and his battle were his charred shorts, leaf headband, and Yamato. He stopped to lean on a tree and tried to fill his lungs with air. You should not chase so desperately after a memory. Has the mere glimpse of her taken away your sense? Illusion, weakness, trap, is it not obvious, young one? As my vassal, you should know better. He merely ignored the Kyuubi as she continued to scold him. Her voice didn't surprise Naruto at all. Her faint whispers had become louder since the battle with Echidna. He scanned the area around him once more. Nothing, wait. His eyes widened as memories surfaced. They looked frighteningly real in his mind's eye. Will you love me? The blonde child asked. I will love you like my own, the woman said, hugging him. Demons don't sniff cry. Devils sniff don't cry. I won't sniff cry, the silver-haired boy cried as he held his dying mother. He held his head in pain as images and emotions ran rampant inside him. Stop it, Kyuubi, he growled out. Is this not what you wish to see, young one? Is this not why you chase after an image so persistently? Kyuubi's voice held confusion and interest as she continued to attack his mind. Naruto could feel her presence all around him as the images kept coming. Stop it! Naruto's eyes flashed red and he mentally lashed out. He found himself in the sewers that were his mindscape. Kyuubi's feminine form laid in a heap in front of him. As soon as he saw her, the red glow returned to his eyes. When I say to stop, you stop! His voice shifted at the end, becoming more demonic. Kyuubi wondered if she pushed too hard as the collar that represented her sealed state tightened around her neck. She did not whimper, she did not gag, she did not beg for mercy even as the darkness crept into her vision. Then it stopped. She gasped for air as Naruto regained control of himself. His thoughts were broken by the pain-filled scream broke into his mindscape. That sounded like the team! He gave Kyuubi a fleeting look before he vanished from the sewers. Kyuubi calmly moved into a sitting position, her tails circling her perfect form. His power grows so quickly, but the weakness he displays is concerning. His soft spot for females, his love for Kairi, and his will to protect those close to him even at the cost of his life. How should I get rid of these weaknesses? Decisions, decisions. Bashed and burned trees were everywhere. The damage looked far greater than any ordinary genin was thought capable of doing. A testament to the chakra-enhanced strength Sakura was developing and the powerful fire jutsus that Sasuke wielded. But none of that had been enough to stop their mysterious attacker. Is there nothing that you can do, Sasuke-kun? She asked mockingly. Or is it that you fear for your teammate's life too much to risk moving? Whoever she was, she stood there yanking viciously on Sakura's hair while Sasuke could do nothing but watch. Come on, Sakura, move. You have to move for it to work. Sasuke's dark eyes looked into Sakura's green, begging her to escape. She suddenly dug into her weapon pouch and grabbed a kunai. Without a moment of hesitation, she swung it behind her head, cutting through her hair with ease. The woman lost her balance as Sakura escaped from her grasp. Sasuke's Sharingan spun to life as he took his opening. Hidden wire he planted during the skirmish were released and binded the woman to a tree. Focusing chakra and going through the necessary hand seals carefully, he unleashed his technique. Ryuka no Jutsu! He poured all his chakra into the attack, unleashing a dragon-shaped flamethrower to fly along the ninja wire. The woman screamed as the attack engulfed her. All became quiet as the flames died down. Sasuke could feel the familiar sensation of chakra exhaustion settle into his body. An overwhelming pressure suddenly fell over him. I can't move. His struggles proved useless. Even if he had not been drained of chakra, the paralysis technique was too strong to throw off. You two should are much better than I expected. The woman's voice steadily became deeper as she spoke. I think you'll do quite nicely. Yes, I've decided you're worthy after all. A sharp pain hit Sasuke's neck and pain flooded his senses. As everything faded into darkness, he faintly heard himself scream out in anguish. Orochimaru chuckled before he saw a flash of pink and felt a fist slam into his cheek. There was no blood or bruises, just a busted lip. Sakura was stunned for a moment before raw determination took over. A flurry of chakra-enhanced punches collided with Orochimaru. Punch after punch, she pushed him back, putting everything she had into the assault. With a shout, she reared back to deliver the final blow. Her entire arm glowed with chakra as it flew towards the snake summoner, only to be effortlessly caught. Sakura watched in horror as the man raised himself out of the splintered tree. Besides a few scratches, he was unharmed. Interesting. For one to have such mastery of their chakra is rare, very rare indeed. Maybe I should mark you as well. I will eventually need a female to sire more Sharingan wielders. Sakura bit back a scream when he shattered her wrist while dropping her to the ground. Or maybe I should just kill you here to prevent another Tsunade. The chance of you surviving the curse mark is slim anyway. A snake slithered out his mouth and produced a sword. You should feel honored, little girl. Not many are worthy enough to die by this blade. Sakura's other arm suddenly lashed out, refusing to give up. Orochimaru blocked it and smirked as he broke it. It fell limp to her side at an unnatural angle. She fell to her knees in front of him and looked up at him with pain-clouded eyes. Orochimaru raised Kusanagi to cut her down. She closed her eyes, but instead of feeling the blade cut through her skin, she felt something wet and warm hit her face. Mud? She opened her eyes to see a familiar sword protruding from the man's chest. Then she heard Naruto's voice. Sorry I took so long, Sakura. That was the last thing she heard before joining Sasuke in unconsciousness. I've been expecting you to show up, Naruto-kun. I was starting to worry Echidna may have been too much of a challenge for you. Orochimaru of the Sannin, why did you attack us? Naruto asked. Defeat me and I just might tell you. The man said, melting into a puddle of mud. To your left! Kyuubi's voice rang out. Naruto spun to his left on instinct to block the blade that would have taken his head off. His human hand trembled as he held off the sword. The ethereal devil bringer came to life and grabbed Orochimaru. Naruto swung the snake summoner into the tree and pinning him there. You'll tell me now! He shouted while increasing his grip. It's a clone. The original is about 50 feet to your right. Good. He's not trying to go after Sakura or Sasuke. The clone spoke up. Why, Naruto-kun, don't you want to play? Though I am disappointed in you. You assume I'm the original. You assume I give a fuck. Naruto clenched his fist and the ethereal copy of his devil bringer did the same, crushing the clone along with tree. Before the tree even had time to fall, Naruto had already turned, swinging his sword with him. Judgment cut! The shockwave blasted toward the surprised Orochimaru, cutting him in half at the waist. However, instead of blood, hundreds of snakes flew from his separated halves and pulled him back together. Naruto did well in keeping the surprise off his face. He slowly got into a ready stance. He extended his human arm behind him and positioning Yamato next to his ear and eye, parallel to the tree under his feet. His devil bringer was outstretched in front of him, trained on Orochimaru. Orochimaru merely laughed. You hide it well, but I can see the exhaustion in your eyes, Naruto-kun. You know I'm one of the Sannin. You could not defeat me even at your best. I don't care if I'm outmatched, I'm not losing. Naruto took a deep breath and focused himself as thousands of strategies went through his mind until he finally settled on the best choice. Are you planning something, Naruto-kun? Maybe a desperate attack to chase me off? How do you know it will work, or even if I am the original? He lies. He is the original and he has no more clones in preparation. Be cautious. You must strike quickly or he will escape. You know, Naruto-kun, I'm always in need of a powerful fighter. With the skill you display, even while weakened, you would be second to none but myself. What is your answer? Naruto thought about the offer while lowering Yamato. My answer. Yes, your answer? A wide grin stretched across his serpentine face. Go blow yourself. Judgment cut. The instant the attack left his blade, Naruto phased out. Air trick. Orochimaru moved to dodge, but another appeared directly behind him, and then one to each side, trapping him. Naruto faded into view far away, jumping through trees with Sasuke and Sakura on his shoulders. Jackpot. The four shockwaves crashed into Orochimaru. Once far enough, Naruto set his teammates down to rest. His chakra was nearly gone. He barely had enough left to function properly. Any more strain and he would defiantly pass out, and that was not an option with Sakura and Sasuke already down. Kakuku, good but not good enough, Naruto-kun. Naruto tried to draw Yamato, but before he could react, Kusanagi had already buried itself into his chest and pinned against the tree. Some of his devil blood's healing powers had returned, but it was only enough to keep him alive. He coughed up a bit of blood. Orochimaru stood looking perfectly fine. The only evidence of the attack was his slightly shredded clothing. That was such an exquisite performance, Naruto-kun. I would be very pleased if you joined my side. He has nothing, young one. He is nothing. Damn, you seriously need a fucking hobby, Naruto said between breaths. Orochimaru's cool demeanor cracked. Why are you so loyal to Konoha? This village mistreated you, shunned you. I bet some have even made attempts on your life. He stopped short, visibly calming himself. I, however, could give you what you want. Knowledge? He would only feed you lies. Power? He probed. He would only hinder your growth out of jealousy and fear, or maybe your loving mother, Kairi. The man said with a dark spark in his eye. No one can raise the dead, Naruto-kun, no one. Orochimaru saw the brief flicker of hope in his eyes. You miss her love, don't you, Naruto-kun? Come forth, Kairi, let him see you. Kairi was suddenly standing inches in front of him, a look of misery on her face. Besides the black form-fitting dress, she hadn't changed at all. But how I saw you died in my arms. He felt numb, and his eyes lost focus as memories came flooding back. Thunder roared in the distance as the sky darkened around them. I could give her back to you, Naruto-kun. All you have to do is pledge your loyalty to me. Orochimaru's words seemed so tempting. Pathetic. What? Naruto asked in a haze. Your teammates died beside you and you would give them up for an empty shell of your memories. Well, Naruto-kun, will you join me? He looked over to Sakura and Sasuke a few feet away. They were both breathing harshly. They would die if he didn't treat them. The silence seemed to stretch on forever. Naruto let out a deep sigh. Never, Naruto said, spitting blood on Orochimaru's face. Orochimaru seemed stunned before rage fully clouded over his normally emotionless face. If you are not my ally, you are my enemy. Kill him, Kairi, he said, walking away. Tears started to cloud Naruto's vision. He looked up into the sky as it began to rain, soaking all of them. Why? Tears were now flowing freely from Kairi's eyes as well. She carefully pulled Kusanagi out of his chest and raised it above her head. Lightning flashed and thunder boomed around them as blood flew. I'm sorry, mother. Naruto stood beside Kairi, Yamato held in his devil bringer. Blood leaked from the sword protruding from her stomach. She slid off the blade and collapsed, dissolving into a completely different person. Orochimaru didn't seem surprised in the slightest by the turn in events. A snake slithered over and brought the discarded Kusanagi back to its summoner's hand. He sneered. What now, half-breed? You have nothing left, and even if you did, I know all of Yamato's and Ifrit's powers. Either will work against me. Then use both, young one. I couldn't call out Ifrit if I tried. Hell, it's taking all I have to just stand. Strange, I've watched you during every battle and not once did you surrender. You always found a way to prevail. I don't have anything left. The power you need is waiting. All you have to call it. Bring out Yamato, bring out Ifrit, and use them as one. It is time you matured, young one, or do you want to give up and die like a weakling? Well, if you put it that way, I guess I have nothing to lose. But why are you helping? Are you kidding? I can't remember the last time I had this much fun. Naruto forced himself to stand tall and raised Yamato to point at Orochimaru. His devil bringer's glow seemed to increase as it tightened around Yamato's hilt. The air became heavy as a blue aura started to circle his form. Orochimaru's eyes widened in surprise. Well, you've proven too dangerous to let live. He rushed Naruto, attempting to cleave him in two with an overhead slash, but was pushed back by an explosion of flames. As the flames were doused by rain, the new Naruto was revealed. Gone was the little boy. In his place was a teen that looked at least 16 with long silver hair that reached the middle of his back. All the baby fat had disappeared. In its place was lean muscle, giving him an athletic look. The charred shorts were gone as well, replaced by his trademark black pants and trench coat. What surprised Orochimaru most of all was the weapon the teen now held. The simple yet elegant katana, Yamato, had transformed into a new blade. It looked more like a massive detailed knife than a sword, with a long red handle and a guard with a lever on it. Naruto's blood-red fox eyes met Orochimaru's serpentine gold. Like it? I call her Red Queen, Yamato combined with Ifrit. The teen's devil bringer arm then began to crawl up his shoulder and spread along his body as the blue aura increased. Naruto's devil trigger form with Red Queen was mostly the same as Yamato except for the few differences. The sheath at his side was gone and he no longer had a spirit hovering behind him, but in their place were two large bat-like wings that sprouted from his back before wrapping around his shoulders, out of the way but still allowing easy access, giving the effect of a cloak or cape on him. The armor was slightly more detailed and had red highlights that gave him a menacing yet regal appearance. Naruto twisted the blade's handle, sending chakra through it. In response, the sword let out what sounded like a cross between a roar and a thunderclap before igniting in flames. It was so hot the rain that touched the blade hissed and evaporated instantly. "You will not forget this devil's power!" For the first time in years, Orochimaru felt a small shiver of fear run down his spine. EX Streak! Instead of the normal streak where Naruto glided along the ground, he spun on his heel with his flaming blade turning him into a swirling vortex of fire. Orochimaru dropped Kusanagi and flew through hand seals. Futon de Tapa! The blast of wind crashed into Naruto, trying to push him back. Naruto's spin began to slow as the flames covering him weakened. Orochimaru allowed a smirk to graze his face. Suddenly, Naruto's flames flared up and his spin increased dramatically, the wind only serving to feed his flames now. Orochimaru screamed as Red Queen cut him in half and the tornado of flames melted his body. The flames were slowly put out by the rain that was still falling. Naruto's devil trigger receded back into his devil bringer, while Red Queen burned down, leaving Yamato. He looked down to find Kusanagi gone, and small pieces of melted rock where Orochimaru had been. The man had escaped. "I'll kill you for what you did to Kairi, even if you are one of the Sannin." He turned back to his teammates. "I need to get them out of here." The rain would continue into the night and hide Naruto's tears of pain. Kyuubi sat calmly on her patch of blood grass. "All according to plan? Now, for the other weaknesses." Slam, the three men turned to the newcomer. "Orochimaru-san, we were beginning to wonder what was holding you." Orochimaru was completely unharmed. "I ran into a few unexpected difficulties, but everything went smoothly, Santa-san. Sasuke is marked, and should he survive, he will find a gift awaiting him." "Did you get Yamato?" the old man asked hopefully. "No, I have something far more valuable." He held up a small tube containing a red liquid. "Is that dash? Agnes stuttered. "Yes, Agnes, it's his blood, collected fresh from the blade of Kusanagi." Orochimaru chuckled. Kirito could not keep the surprise off his face. The possibilities, finally. Naruto had managed to reset and heal Sakura's arms with a minor medical jutsu. She wouldn't be able to use them for a while, but they'd be as good as new once they completely healed. Sasuke was a different matter entirely. His body rejected the healing jutsu completely. All Naruto could do is wrap the worst of his wounds to prevent infection and try to break his fever. The rejection seemed to have something to do with the strange mark on his neck. "You just can't make it simple, can you, team?" Naruto walked unsteadily to the front of his makeshift hideout in the tree trunk to keep guard. His balance was thrown off slightly by whatever had happened. He had been moving on instinct against Orochimaru, but with the drive gone, the awkwardness of his growth spurt settled in. The rain had stopped, leaving the forest quiet except for the occasional mindless chatter of a passing demon. "What happened?" "I went from 13 to 16 in seconds. I'm sure you know Kyuubi. Devil maturation. What the hell's that supposed to mean?" "Devils fight by nature. To fight, they must mature faster than humans. So a demon will grow into its prime anywhere from a week to a few years. They go from child to adult, skipping adolescence completely. Once they reach adulthood, they remain in their prime for years longer than humans to fight and mate." "What about old age? Demons don't have an elder stage either. The lifespan of a demon directly depends on how powerful it is. If not killed in battle, their body will eventually just give out. But this rarely happens, as they are more often killed in battle. The weaker a class of demon is, the more of them there are. Scarecrows and chimera seeds are among the most common of demon, but they are pathetic. Demons like Burial and Echidna, however, are much stronger, but as a result, they are the only one of their kind." "Alright, now how do I fit into this?" "You have a balance of human and demonic blood, but you started out mostly human, so your body would still progress through adolescence. But in the condition you were in, you had no chance in fighting the snake off. While you called upon your demonic power, I charged you with my chakra and tapped into that demon heritage. It allowed your body to feed and grow directly from my chakra, refreshing your power." "They approach. About time. They've been watching us for the past hour." "What's this, Dosu? You think the Leaf Genin's teammates are hurt? What the hell happened to you anyway? Whatever, how about you move aside so we can kill Sasuke?" The boy with spiky hair mocked as he walked out of the bushes with the mummy-looking genin that must have been Dosu. Ignoring the idiot, he thought over what they said. "Orochimaru wants them to kill Sasuke? That coward has a lot of nerve to send lackeys to do his dirty work." Naruto then got a good look at the girl that walked out behind them. "Not bad. Be careful, Zaku. You saw his arm. We don't know what he's capable of. He must be confident if he didn't set any traps. The girl cautioned the boy named Zaku. Come on, Kin, the guy looks dash. Hey, babe. Naruto called out. Kin seemed startled at Naruto's sudden attention. Who, me? She asked, pointing to herself. Well, I don't see any other babes around. How about you ditch those losers and I show you what a real ninja is like? Naruto smiled as she blushed bright red. You're asking her for a date? Zaku asked. Well, yeah. Just because you two are too stupid to see how hot she is doesn't mean I am. Naruto wanted to laugh at the stupid looks on the boys' faces. That's it, you're dead. Zaku raised his arms, exposing the small holes in the center of his palm. Zankyo Kukua! A huge blast of air left his palms, tearing up the ground as it shot toward Naruto. The demon hunter stood calmly as the attack seemed to approach in slow motion. Judgment cut! Naruto muttered. The crescent blue shockwave exploded from his blade and canceled out the blast of wind easily. The three looked on in shocked silence. Then they blinked and Naruto was gone. Zaku felt a hand grab his shoulder and squeeze painfully, forcing him to his knees. He craned his neck slightly to see Naruto. Now you have two choices. One, I can kill you and take your scroll, but that would be messy and I need to get my team out of here. Or two, you can give me your scroll and leave. Naruto said calmly. Zaku spit at him, missing his face by inches. What makes you think you can beat all three of us at once? Naruto sighed and gave him a bored look. I can kill you and the mummy over there in a matter of moments. And the girl? By the time I'm through with her, she won't even remember her name, and it won't be from pain. Kin blushed. Dosu took out the scroll and rolled it in front of Naruto and Zaku. Naruto gave Zaku a harsh squeeze. Pick it up and hand it to me. Naruto said. Zaku slowly reached out before twisting out of the grip. Zen dash. Yamato flashed and numerous cuts suddenly littered Zaku's body. Blood spurted from the wounds and Zaku fell to the ground. Dosu was already moving away, but a slash caught him, trailing from the left side of his hip to his right shoulder. And before Kin could even think of moving, two strong arms wrapped around her waist. Don't worry, the cuts were shallow, but they won't be getting up for a while. Relax. She shuddered as his hot breath hit her ear and turned her head to catch sight of two hypnotizing red eyes. Lie morning. The girl closed her eyes and bit back a moan as his hand snaked under her shirt and started to massage her breast. Naruto gave her ear a light nip, then moved to leave a trail of soft kisses on her neck and felt her nipples harden. He gave one a small pinch and the girl gasped and moaned, turning to putty in his hands. Naruto's devil bringer trailed down, lightly dragging a clawed finger to her waiting maidenhood. The girl's knees gave out as he began to stroke her lower lips. He caught her with no trouble, slipping a finger inside her and began thrusting at a steady pace. She was nearly screaming now, and he could feel the girl's arousal soak her panties and leak down her legs. He sucked on her neck while pinching her nipple again. The combined pleasure sent her over the edge. She spasmed and let out one final scream before collapsing in his arms. End line. He felt his canines sharpen as he moved to mark her neck. Contain yourself. Can you not feel the vile chakra tainting the air? He stopped short as Kyuubi's words broke through his lust-filled mind. Damn it. Why now? Naruto set the girl down gently and turned his frustrated gaze to the cluster of trees that hid Sakura and Sasuke. A blur crashed into a swiftly drawn Yamato. The claymore crackled with electricity as it struggled to overpower him. The hand that held the blade was covered in black flame-like markings that seemed to come from the seal on his neck. He wields a laster! A demented smile split Sasuke's face as he spoke. I'll kill you with this power, Itachi. The Uchiha was obviously hallucinating. The shadow of Naruto's hair covered his face from view. Sasuke frowned. Do you give up so easily, Itachi? You. Naruto's voice was low but quickly gained intensity. Have the worst timing ever. Naruto used Yamato to bat his sword arm away and sent his head crashing into the Uchiha's. Blood leaked from his forehead and the boy's eyes rolled into the back of his head. Crumpling to the ground, the flame marks receding while the broadsword called the laster disappeared in a flash of electricity. Naruto turned to look longingly at the disheveled girl who laid on the ground with glossy eyes, a wistful smile, and a line of drool coming out of her mouth. He then turned back to his downed teammates. Arg! Damn it! Kakashi and his fucking Nindo! Naruto jumped off with theirs and the sound team's scroll in his pockets and Sakura and Sasuke on his shoulders. Kin would soon come to her senses, beat red, and try to hide the evidence of what happened before kicking her teammates awake. She wouldn't be able to hide the bright blush that would appear when one of her teammates cursed out Naruto's name. Naruto, watch out! Sakura's eyes snapped open and she shot up. She tried to grab a kunai, but her arms wouldn't move. She felt panic rise in her chest at her helpless state. "Calm down, Sakura. Naruto's fine, just different." Her eyes adjusted as she turned to see Sasuke sitting over a small fire. "Naruto said for you not to move too much, you're still recovering."
"Yeah."
She looking down at her arms. "Where is Naruto?" Sasuke rubbed his neck and Sakura saw the strange mark their attacker left on him. "Said he needed to scout once I woke up."
"What's wrong?"
She looked down and her sight became blurry with tears. "All the blood, sweat, and tears we put into our training and he still defeated us like academy students." She choked back a sob. "We could have died." The stress from the attack must have been tough on her. Sasuke wrapped his arms around her and pulled her close. After losing so much, he didn't want to lose Sakura to insanity like he did Itachi. "Just this once for her," he told himself. But as she cried herself back to sleep, he couldn't help but feel he needed the comfort just as much as she did. The strange nightmare and the promises of power still plagued his mind. Kabuto spied on the moment between the two genin. She could prove to be a problem in Orochimaru-sama's plans. Should I approach them or leave? While both of them are weakened, Naruto could prove challenging even with my skill. Cold steel pressed into his neck.
"Why are you spying on my team, Kabuto?"
Naruto asked dangerously. A line of blood trailed down his neck from where the blade touched. "Guess that's my answer." Kabuto fell lifelessly to the ground and Naruto saw a figure to his right. Summon sword shot out, but the figure had already escaped. He checked the body.
"No way, this guy is already dead. Genin, my ass."
He waked out to Sasuke holding the sleeping Sakura in his arms.
"We're leaving. Get what we need. I'll carry Sakura. You're still weak. She'd only be a burden to you,"
he said, grabbing Sakura bridle style, and with Sasuke jumped off toward the tower.
"Give us your scrolls and we'll let you live."
Naruto and Sasuke were surrounded by dozens of genin with breathing devices on their faces. Naruto handed the still sleeping Sakura to Sasuke.
"I got a better idea,"
Naruto said, walking into the open.
"I kill you guys, take your scroll, and leave you to rot while we get our teammate to that tower."
The army laughed together.
"We have you surrounded, there is way you can kill us."
Naruto's eyes hardened.
"You guys picked the wrong team to fuck with today."
Blue summon blade shot out, tearing the genin in front of Naruto to sheds.
"Hiding behind an illusion, huh? Kage Bunshin no Jutsu."
The silver-haired genin multiplied in numbers. Each and every illusion was cut down in an instant. Naruto heard a whimper and turned to see the originals cowering in the bushes. He froze them in place with killing intent.
"Have mercy," one whimpered.
If it was possible, Naruto's eyes hardened even further.
"Sorry, I'm all out of mercy."
Their screams sent shivers down Sasuke's spine.
"I'm sorry, Orochimaru-sama. I was unable to watch over Uchiha Sasuke during the second exam,"
Kabuto said, bowing. Orochimaru chuckled.
"I didn't expect you would be able to. But I'm curious, what is your opinion on the Uzumaki boy? The Kyuubi container? I believe he is extremely dangerous,"
Kabuto answered.
"Yes, I thought so as well, but what if we convinced him to switch sides? I find that our rate of success would increase dramatically, Orochimaru-sama. You are dismissed, Kabuto-kun."
As soon as he left, Orochimaru called out.
"Taiyuya-chan."
"Yes, Orochimaru-sama?"
The disguised girl appeared kneeling in front of him.
"I have a mission for you, Taiyuya-chan."
Sakura groaned as her eyes fluttered open, trying to adjust to the sunlight. It felt as if she was being held. She caught a flash of silver.
"Naruto-kun?
Hehe, so saving you puts me in Sasuke's league, Sakura-chan?"
She blushed as her eyes finished adjusting, then gasped.
"What?"
Naruto asked.
"Finally noticed that I look better than Sasuke?"
Naruto smiled, seeing Sasuke's eye twitch. Sakura's blush increased further.
You look.
Hot, her inner persona finished for her. Not that he wasn't hot before. She corrected herself.
"Older?"
"Yeah, I think something happened with my Kekkei Genkai,"
Naruto said. They stopped in front of a door with the seal for open on it.
"About damn time we got here,"
Naruto said, walking up to the door. Sakura moved to be let down, but shot Naruto a curious look when he tightened his grip.
"You can let me down now, Naruto."
"Hell no.
If you haven't forgotten, you're still hurt. The last thing you need to be doing is straining yourself,"
he said while raising a leg. His foot collided into the doors, breaking them off the hinges and sending them to shatter against the far wall. Naruto took a look around.
"What the hell? There's no one here."
Sakura caught sight of the paper that hung against one of the walls.
"Hey, look at that. Heaven and Earth?
That's it.
Naruto, give me the scrolls."
Naruto gave Sasuke an odd look.
All right, hold on a sec."
Sakura let out a startled squeal as Naruto threw her over his shoulder.
"Naruto?"
Sakura asked.
"What?"
The devil hunter asked, scrounging his pockets.
Your hands on my butt, she said.
Naruto stopped. She let out a surprised squeak when she felt a light caress and a squeeze.
So,
he said cheekily, retrieving the scrolls and tossing them to Sasuke. Sakura huffed in annoyance while Sasuke opened the scrolls and threw them away as they started to smoke. Naruto sat Sakura on the ground and tensed. The smoke cleared away to reveal.
Iruka-sensei?
The three visibly relaxed.
Hey guys!
Just in time, any longer, and you would have been disqualified. Iruka said, smiling. Loud knocks pelted the apartment's door. Lady had to stop herself from running at the mere thought of Naruto's return. Throwing the door open, she couldn't help the disappointment that filled her tone.
Oh, it's only you,
she absently wondered when she started missing Naruto so much.
You okay?
You don't look so good. Hannah stumbled in the apartment. The girl looked more feral than the last time seen, with disheveled hair, more prominent canines, and a wild look in her eyes.
I need Naruto-kun. Is he here?
No, he's still at the Chunin exams. Why? Lady answered, closing the door behind the Inazuka.
I'm in heat.
As Sarutobi explained the third exam, he looked over the seven teams who had made it past the second exam. Four of them from Konoha and three of the four were still rookies, having graduated only a year ago. He resisted the urge to smile at them. He did, however, nod in the new Naruto's direction approvingly. Strange that the boy avoided his gaze. Naruto had already explained his sudden growth to Iruka, and while not detailed, it had something to do with his bloodline. Stranger still, most of the Kuniochi were sneaking glances at the new Naruto and blushing. Even the Kazekage's daughter was not immune to the boy's charm. The redhead seemed completely smitten with him and ready to attack any of the Kunoichi beside her.
No,
Sarutobi said, wrapping his speech up.
On to the third exam. Please excuse my interruption, Hokage-sama, but if you don't mind, I'll take over from here.
The sickly-looking man asked, Shun shining in front of him.
Not at all,
Sarutobi answered.
Hey, Hayate-sensei. I see you still look as ill as ever,
Naruto shouted.
As for you who do not know me, I am Gekko Hayate and protector of the third exam. But it seems that we still have too many genin, so we will be holding preliminaries.
Cries of outrage came from all the genin, except one.
Well, what are we waiting for? Let's get this party started!
Naruto shouted over the complaints. Anko nudged Kakashi in the ribs, causing his one eye to look away from his book and focus on her.
I like that one, Kakashi. Can I have him?
She said, pointing at Naruto.
Kakashi's eye returned to his book. If you can get past the girls that have already sunk their claws into him,
Anko pouted.
Oh, I don't want to share. Oh well, guess I'll just go after you instead,
the woman said with a thoughtful look.
Guess so.
The Kapinin was once again engrossed in his book.
What?
Kakashi looked back at her with a wide eye.
Nothing.
She gave him an evil smile.
I'm just plotting, don't mind me.
Kakashi closed his book and continued to watch her warily out the corner of his eye.
Now anyone who feels they are not able physically or mentally to compete may forfeit now,
the coughing jounin said.
Well, I'm out of here then,
Kabuto said, raising his hand. Naruto tensed as Kabuto passed by him. Forcing himself to relax, he glanced at an unmoving Sakura.
Not going to forfeit? Those arms of yours are still useless,
Sakura smiled.
No way. I can't stop thinking of it as a challenge. You and Sasuke-kun are rubbing off on me.
Naruto looked at the pink-haired girl with a new respect. Even Sasuke looked at Sakura in a new light. The fangirl was gone. This girl standing in front of them was a Konochi.
Now if you would turn your attention to the board, we can begin.
The section on the wall behind Hayate rumbled, sliding open to reveal an electronic display board that was already shuffling through names. Uchiha Sasuke vs Akado Yoroi.
Would the two fighters step forward? All others clear the battlefield and make your way to the observation area.
Both boys walked up while the others made their way to the upper balconies.
Don't use the Sharingan,
Kakashi said as he passed Sasuke.
How'd you know?
Sasuke asked, surprised. Kakashi either didn't hear the question or didn't care, most likely the latter.
If the examiners see any signs of the curse mark beginning to take over, you will be disqualified,
the man finished, walking away.
Disqualified?
Sasuke's eye twitched at the slight throb of pain the curse mark gave off. The masked boy across from him caught it and chuckled.
It's not too late to give up, Sasuke-kun,
he said mockingly. Sasuke ignored him. This thing seems to respond to my chakra. That just leaves me with taijutsu.
It's your fault, we're weak,
a younger version of himself shouted. Sasuke shook off the images of his nightmare.
Begin!
He grabbed a kunai to deflect the shuriken thrown at him, but the curse seal flared painfully, sending him to the ground.
It's your fault Itachi killed mom and dad,
the boy continued while peeling away a layer of his skin off his face to reveal serpentine eyes. Vyuchiha looked up and rolled out of the way of a fist that crushed the ground where he had been previously. Digging his kunai into the ground as a break, he hooked his feet around the masked genin's leg and took it out from under him. He then brought the boy's arm into a painful-looking arm lock. The masked nin grabbed the Uchiha by his collar with a glowing hand. The Sharingan wielder could feel his strength fade at the contact. Akato then broke his grip and sent a strong punch into his chin. Twisting around, he grabbed the Uchiha's head with his glowing hand. Sasuke tried to pry the genin's hand from his head, but his strength left him, and his arms fell to his sides.
"You let them die!" His snake-eyed counterpart cried in anguish.
Sasuke grabbed his discarded kunai and plunged the blade into the masked genin's arm. The boy cried out in pain as the metal bit into his skin. The curse seal began to flare and electricity crackled around the kunai, burning the skin around it. Sasuke kicked the boy away and tried to fight off the vile but addicting chakra. "I don't need this power to defeat him." The curse seal receded and Sasuke let out a sigh of relief. For some reason, his kunai felt heavier. He looked down to find an intricate claymore crackling with electricity in his hand. A deep voice spoke in his head.
"I am a laster, the weapon of an avenger. The weak shall give their heart and swear their eternal loyalty to me. Can you control my power?"
Sasuke moved in a stance he'd seen Naruto use so much. "Watch me." Naruto recognized his streak attack stance. "Even if you do have a sword, I doubt you can pull it off on the first try. Do not doubt the power of a laster, my vassal. Dante used it with Ifrit to defeat Mundus." Kyuubi spoke softly. "The Uchiha will either become a powerful ally or a deadly enemy. A laster will not have a weak arm wield him." Sasuke glided forward and took a powerful step while thrusting his blade. The resemblance was similar to Naruto's stake attack, but was fit for a weapon that pierced instead of cut. Akato's eyes widened as the blade stabbed through his chest and burst out his back in an explosion of blood.
"But I thought Konoha shinobi were too soft to kill,"
Akato said, coughing up blood. Sasuke pulled his blade from the boy's chest, letting him fall to his knees, then wiped it on his shoulder to clean off the blood.
"You thought wrong,"
the Uchiha said simply with no emotion. The masked genin's eyes glazed over and he fell to the ground.
"Uchiha Sasuke is the winner!"
Hate shouted to the crowd as the medics bustled to remove Sasuke's corpse. Many of the Konoha genin were stunned that Sasuke had actually killed his opponent, but the Suna genin and Team 7 were unfazed. Team 7 had already been introduced to killing.
"Hey, that's my move, you bastard!"
Naruto shouted. Sasuke looked up and smirked.
"That's my move, Naruto. It's stinger, not streak."
A hand came to rest on his shoulder.
"Not bad making your own technique from Naruto's. Now let's get rid of that seal, shall we?"
Kakashi said. They both disappeared in a cloud of smoke. Naruto just crossed his arms and sighed.
"What a fucking copycat. I'm going to have to show him how it's done when we fight,"
he said, glancing at the board shifting through names. Zaku Ibumi vs Aburame Shino. Zaku smirked, confident in his victory even with his bandaged body.
"Who's this loser?"
When both entered the stadium, Zaku a little stiffly due to his injuries, Hate brought his hand up.
"Second match, begin,"
he said, bringing his arm down.
"Do you think Shino-kun will be alright?"
Hinata stuttered after the Aburame got hit with a Zenkaha. Kiba remained silent, contrasting greatly with his normal loud personality.
"I sure Shino will be fine, Hinata,"
Kurina answered, giving the Inazuka a strange look.
"What happened to him?"
Sakura asked. The boy's body was covered in bandages, most taking on a red tinge from his movement.
"Yamato,"
Naruto said simply. Shino had already trapped Zaku in a type of bug technique. Sasuke swallowed the scream that threatened to escape as intricate seals slithered up his body to circle the cursed seal. He let himself fall to the floor when the sealing was finished.
"This seal will hold back the cursed mark should it awaken in the future, Sasuke, but only if you have the will for it to do so. Its power is derived from you. Should you lose yourself, the seal will weaken and the cursed mark will run rampant,"
Kakashi explained. Sasuke closed his eyes and relished in the feel of the cold stone on his burning flesh as exhaustion claimed him.
"So advanced in the methods of sealing, I see. But it will do little good."
Kakashi turned to face the snake summoner, his visible eye narrowing.
"Orochimaru, you think my influence over him is just manifested through the seal, but it is also the sword. A laster is a powerful weapon, but difficult to control. He'll need the curse seal to master it,"
the snake Sennin said, walking out of the shadows.
"Just what are you after?"
"Why, I want your team, Kakashi. I was just going to take Sasuke for the Sharingan, but soon the rumors of the Kyuubi boy caught my interest, and then the girl surprised me in the forest.
I really must thank you for developing them so well for me. But I'll be taking them off your hands soon.
The snake Sannin cackled insanely. He was cut off by the sudden sound of a thousand birds.
I won't let that happen, Kakashi said dangerously, holding his signature move.
Oh really, just how do you plan to do that?
The rift between them is small now, but it will grow.
Hasn't the council already forbidden you from teaching Naruto in order to focus on Sasuke?
How dash?
Kakashi's attack faded from view. Orochimaru began to walk away, leaving his back wide open.
Don't look so surprised, Kakashi. The council is so very predictable.
It's funny, really, even with the Hokage defending them. The council is becoming increasingly suspicious of the women that live with the boy. And yet, if they only looked under their noses, they would see me.
The man finished, fading back into the shadows.
Kakashi picked up Sasuke.
I don't care how powerful you are, Orochimaru. I'll kill you if you threaten my team, even if I die in the process.
So what I miss, guys? Kakashi asked, walking out a cloud of smoke.
Sometime while he was gone, Gai and his pupil, Lee, had joined Naruto and Sakura along with the Kazekage's red-headed daughter, who seemed content just to cling to Naruto.
Nothing, just a puppet fighting a rubber band, Naruto answered.
He was seemingly unfazed by the redhead clinging to his arm, or the fact that she was between him and Sakura and giving the pink-haired girl wary glances whenever she got too close.
Naruto must be oblivious to not see the girl's affection.
Little did Kakashi know, Naruto wasn't nearly as oblivious as he was believed to be.
Will Sasuke-kun be alright, Kakashi-sensei?
Sakura asked.
He'll be fine, but I think he should be more focused on your fight,
Kakashi said, pointing at the electronic board that had chosen the next fighters. Haruno Sakura vs Yamanaka Ino.
Match 4, begin.
Give up, Ino. You can't beat me, Sakura said.
Don't get cocky with me, forehead girl.
Without arms, you don't have any jutsu,
Ino shouted, forgetting her brief concern for her friend.
Who said anything about me using jutsu?
Sakura raised her leg and stomped the ground, causing a spiderweb of cracks in the stone.
I've gotten nowhere near to mastering this, but I'm getting pretty good at it.
Most of the spectators were in awe of the technique not seen since Tsunade left. The Jounin were all thinking along the same lines.
Just what the hell has Kakashi been teaching those kids?
None really expected the lazy Jounin to train his genin. To say they were surprised was an understatement. First, the Uchiha is able to generate and focus lightning chakra through a weapon, and now the girl has phenomenal chakra control to the point of recreating Tsunade's legendary strength to a certain degree.
All of them glanced at the silver-haired member of the Kapunin's team, wondering what his skills were.
What was that?
Lee asked.
It couldn't be her strength alone.
That, my youthful student, is chakra control, Gai answered in serious tone, glancing at Kakashi.
I was not aware you had the knowledge to teach such high-level chakra control, Kakashi.
It was her alone who expanded on her control.
I merely taught the basics and guided her,
the one-eyed Jounin answered back calmly.
Sakura rushed forward and ducked under the blonde's punch while driving her knee into the girl's stomach.
Ino stumbled away, but Sakura didn't press her attack.
Stop holding back, Ino, because from here on I'm not, Sakura said, charging again.
When did she change so much? Ino thought as she ducked under a roundhouse and punched the pink-haired girl.
While Sakura outmatched her in strength and speed, her attacks were limited and slow without the use of her arms.
Sakura stumbled back for a brief instant before retaliating with a strong kick.
Ino crossed her arms in front and sent as much chakra as she could in a hasty block.
The kick slammed into her guard and sent her flying back.
Shifting her weight, Ino used her momentum to backflip and land on her feet.
With just one kick, she almost broke both my arms, even though enhanced with chakra.
What's wrong, Ino? All that hair getting in the way?
Sakura tensed when Ino reached into her weapons pouch, only to be surprised when she cut her ponytail off.
This means nothing to me,
the girl shouted before throwing the hair to the ground and making the hand sign for Shintenshin.
I'll make you give up, Shintenshin no jutsu.
Sakura moved to dodge but found her legs caught by chakra-guided hair.
Ino's body slumped while Sakura continued to stand still.
Suddenly she spoke.
Examiner, I Haruno Sakura dash.
She grabbed her head in pain.
Ino, get out of my head.
Ino was hit with a force to put an enraged Akimichi to shame. She found herself back in her own body with Sakura hovering above her.
She ejected me.
The blonde found herself unable to move.
I don't have anything left, she sighed.
I yield. As soon as the words left Ino's mouth, Sakura's legs collapsed, but was caught by Kakashi before she hit the ground.
Asuma appeared to gather Ino in his arms.
You did well, Ino, he said gruffly.
Kakashi brought Sakura back to the balcony. He set her on the ground gently.
I'm very proud, Sakura.
Thanks, Kakashi-sensei.
she said. Tenten vs Temari. Naruto watched as the weapon mistress's attack was shut down despite her green-clad teammates' cheers. Gaara's sister defeated her easily by catching her in an high-level wind jutsu, and catching her with the battle fan where the bun-haired girl bent at a painful angle. Lee was furious by the Sannin's disrespect toward his teammate but was held back by Gai. Nara Shikamaru vs Kintsugi. Naruto found his want for Kin dwindle as he saw her out-strategized so easily by the Nara, despite his genius. No jutsu besides a bell technique and very basic abilities, he couldn't even see any potential. With the lust that came from your sudden maturation, you saw her only as a female. Now you see she will not last if you mark her. There is no place for weakness among your mates. Naruto sighed. She was right, as much as it annoyed him to admit that. Inazuka Kiba vs Uzumaki Naruto. About damn time, Naruto said. And why you? She asked, tilting her head in question. Naruto turned to her and patted her head, which she leaned into. Don't worry, I'll be back before you know it. The demon hunter blurred and reappeared in the arena with air trick, shocking the spectators. They were all eager to see what the last member of Kakashi's team was capable of. Asuma noticed even Shikamaru was watching intently. So what's this one's power? The Uchiha is skilled with the sword he summoned, and the girl's chakra control is phenomenal. The man wondered while studying the boy's arm. And that arm is unlike any bloodline I've ever seen. Kurenai was confident in Kiba's victory. The Inazuka was top in his class in taijutsu. There's no way he'd lose to the dead last. Lucky me, Kiba said seriously, jumping over the railing. I'll make that bastard pay for marking Hana. Match 7, begin, Hate said. Kami, show me how far you've come, Naruto. Kiba calmly took out two chakra pills out. So it was your scent. I wasn't sure before, but now I'm positive. It was you who marked Hana. I marked Hana? Naruto wondered before realizing something. Shit. That must have been why she acted so weird after our battle. Kiba swallowed one pill and gave the other to Akamaru, turning the dogs for red. He then brought his hands together in a seal. Shikyaka no jutsu. The Inazuka got down on all fours and suddenly took on a more feral appearance. Now, Akamaru. The small puppy jumped on his back. Jujin Bunshin. In a burst of smoke, the dog was replaced by a second Kiba that looked just as feral as the first. She may be okay with it, but I'm not. Show me you can protect her, the original said while both bounded on all fours at Naruto with impressive speed. If that's the way you want it, I'll gladly kick your ass, Naruto said, unsheathing Yamato. Not so fast. The Inazuka let loose a smoke bomb, blanketing the area in front of him in smoke. Getsuga. Two small vortexes tore into the blinded Naruto, sending him crashing into the wall with enough force to make a small crater. You're not good enough for my sister, the original Kiba spat. The other took a few steps closer to stiff the air. That's it, Asuma thought in obvious disappointment. You taught the Uchiha and the girl, but not him? I knew it. The boy is still just the dead last, Kurenai thought. Both were stunned by what happened next. Naruto blurred in front of one of the Inazuka, slamming his devil bringer arm into his face. The Kiba flew back but was caught by the ethereal form of Naruto's arm and thrown into the air. He blurred out with an air trick and reappeared behind the Kiba, swinging his sword down to summon a judgment cut. The blue crescent slammed into the Kiba, sending him crashing into the ground. Naruto landed lightly next to the smoking trench. The smoke cleared, revealing the small dog whimpering weakly. It's just you and me, dog breath, Naruto said, sheathing Yamato. I'll tear you apart. The Inazuka recklessly charged at Naruto in anger. Naruto's human arm blocked the wild slash aimed for his head. A powerful uppercut from Naruto's ethereal devil bringer knocked Kiba off his feet. Naruto caught him by his collar with his human hand and reared his ethereal devil bringer back. The silver-haired devil hunter then unleashed a flurry of punches on the Inazuka that slowly increased in intensity. Kiba felt the world around him disappear when the glowing devil bringer slammed into his stomach. He fell to his knees, coughing up blood, and almost slid down to the ground. But Naruto picked him up by his head and forcing him to look up. I'm not interested in your bullshit. When I marked Hana, she became mine. I'll destroy anything that tries to harm her. Naruto's ethereal devil bringer then crashed into the Inazuka's face, sending him across the arena. Hate went to check the Inazuka. Strange, the boy is beat up but nothing is broken or ruptured. It's almost as if Naruto pulled held back in that assault. Hate looked back at the boy who was pulling his sleeve over his demonic appendage. Winner Uzumaki Naruto! The coughing Jounin finally announced. The medics were quick to gather up Kiba and avoid Naruto like the plague. Now that's more like it, Asuma thought. That bloodline limit is something else. Impossible! Kurenai couldn't believe her crimson eyes. He defeated Kiba so easily.
Hyuga Hinata vs Hyuga Neji.
I never thought that I'd be meet you here, Hinata-sama.
Neji said with a cruel smirk.
And Neji Dash. The heiress, one of the noble founding clans of Konoha. Stuttering. Don't you have any pride? I wonder if you even had the nerve to join this exam of your own will? Or did you believe your teammates could protect you? I entered to change myself.
Hinata shouted, betraying her shy nature.
I can see with my eyes that you will never change.
Neji said, activating his Bakugan.
Then you are truly blind.
Neji's veined eyes focused on Naruto, the one who spoke.
I see the potential in her.
Naruto's support was all Hinata needed to focus. She calmly slid into a gentle fist stance. Neji looked shocked by her sudden boldness, but moved into a stance that mirrored hers. The distance between them closed in a flash, and they were soon in a beautiful but deadly dance that was the gentle fist fighting style. The blows were so powerful that the chakra could be seen when deflected or blocked. Naruto struggled to keep his temper in check as the fight raged on. It became apparent that Neji outclassed Hinata in terms of skill when his closed her tenkutsu.
How can he do that to his own family?
Naruto said, watching Neji brutally knock the girl down only for her to struggle back to her feet. Faint traces of red was beginning to bleed into Naruto's blue eyes. NYU's presence kept him from acting rashly, but when Neji went for the killing blow, even though he already won, Naruto lost it. Neji found himself looking into blood-red eyes that made his blood run cold. Yamato trembled near his neck. The only thing keeping it back was Hide's blade. Kakashi stood behind Naruto holding his Devil Bringer in a hammerlock. Guy caught Neji in a headlock to keep his chakra-enhanced palm from striking anyone. Kurenai appeared next to a pale Hinata.
Stand down, Naruto. That's an order,
Kakashi said calmly, but in a tone that left no room for argument. Naruto's eyes lost their red glow as he sheathed Yamato. Kakashi released him, but was standing in a place where he could intercept the boy easily should he try to go after Neji. Hinata suddenly collapsed, coughing up blood, and Naruto was there to catch her. Naruto could faintly hear someone calling for the medics. Everything seemed to slow down. It was like watching Kairi die all over again.
No. I will never let that happen again.
With everyone watching, Naruto brought his glowing Devil Bringer above Hinata's chest and let the soothing blue light seep into her. Kakashi moved to hold Kurenai back while uncovering his Sharingan.
Get him away from her!
The Genjutsu mistress shouted.
Wait, Kurenai! He's healing her!
Kakashi could see Naruto's chakra flowing into Hinata to neutralize Neji's. When the glow finally faded, Hinata was breathing normally. Naruto took a deep breath and turned, unleashing focused killing intent on Neji.
If we meet in the finals, I will crush you!
And with an air trick, Naruto was back on the balcony, leaving Hinata in the Medenin's care. Rock Lee vs Gaara. Lee's eyes seemingly set on fire.
Yosh! It's my turn and I will not disappoint!
He jumped down eager for his fight. NYU's went from innocent to annoyed, showing her shift in personalities before disappearing in a swirl of sand. Lee's taijutsu was extraordinary, but he didn't get in any solid hits. Even when he took off his weights, the green beast only managed to land in a single axe kick. When he opened 5 of the 8 chakra gates, he became powerful enough to break Gaara's defense, but after using the gates, the green beast was nothing but a sitting duck. Gaara, who had survived the powerful Yuuzhan, surprised all of the sand and sound ninjas by not moving in for the kill. The match went to Gaara because Lee was unable to continue. Since Lee didn't sustain any damage other than the gates themselves, he was expected to, in time, make a full recovery. As soon as the match was called, Gaara appeared next to Naruto in a swirl of sand. Still in her Gaara persona, she asked,
"Did I do good, Naruto-kun?"
"Yeah, I'm very proud of you for not killing him,"
he said, patting her on the head. She smiled and, much to his embarrassment, and Sakura's and Kakashi's amusement, glomped him. "She's not exactly what I expected when they warned us of the sand Jinchuriki," Kakashi thought while watching Naruto smile at the girl who had shifted back to the NYU persona. "But you can bring out the good in anyone if you try hard enough, Naruto." The last match between Choji and Dosu was kind of pathetic, really. Choji attacked with his clan technique, but when he stopped, Dosu managed to take him out in one hit. The Akimichi was quickly moved by the medics. The Hokage now stood in front of the winners.
"Congratulations on passing the preliminaries. Now please draw a number from the box Anko has to decide the order of the final exam."
Naruto didn't miss the sly look Anko gave Kakashi when he drew for 2 of his students. Naruto 1, Sakura 10, Sasuke 4, Shikamaru 8, Kankuro 5, Dosu 9, Gaara 3,
Temari 7, Neji 2, Shino 6. Ibiki showed them a chart giving the order for the finals. Match 1, Uzumaki Naruto vs. Hyuga Neji. Match 2, Sabaka no Gaara vs. Uchiha Sasuke. Match 3, Kankuro vs. Aburame Shino. Match 4, Temari vs. Nara Shikamaru. Match 5, Kinyuta Dosa vs. Haruno Sakura. Neji couldn't help the shiver that went down his spine when he caught the Uzumaki boy glaring at him. Faint traces of red bleeding into his eyes. Naruto groggily woke up to the sound of someone knocking on his door. He ignored it and pulled the nearest pillow closer to him for warmth. But when that pillow let out a small, tired moan and snuggled into him, his eyes shot open to find all his mates in bed with him. And no matter how hard he tried, all he could remember from yesterday was the Chunin exams. He didn't even remember how he got back.
My poor vassal, you can't remember?
I sure can, Kyuubi said, mocking him.
What happened?
Damn it. A devil's lust can't be suppressed forever. But when I released it, your mates were all too happy to sate that lust when you came back. It was so very satisfying to watch through your eyes.
You possessed me?
No, it was all you. A different side of you, but you nonetheless. The teen was brought out of thought by the person's relentless knocking. Whoever he or she was, they were determined to speak to him or break down the door. Untangling himself from the women, causing some tired groans, he slipped on a pair of boxers that were laying around while making his way to the door. He opened it a crack and peered out.
What do you want, closet pervert?
After making sure his room door was closed, the teen opened the door. Ebisu seemed to stumble over himself at the degrading, but true, nickname.
That is Ebisu-sensei to you. Are you deaf?
I have been knocking for the past 10 minutes.
And such indecency is inexcusable.
I was sleeping and this is my house. The teen answered evasively.
What do you want?
Why, if I had been an assassin dash, you'd be dead right now, and I could have sworn I heard voices. The tutor said, looking around the apartment behind the teen.
Listen, I'm going to make this as simple as possible. You tell me why you're here or my door is going to slam in your face.
The man stood a little straighter.
How dare you? Kakashi sent me with a scroll. I believe it contains training exercises you are to do while he's away.
Away? The teen asked, taking the scroll.
Yes, away. He must train the Uchiha to face the Sand Master.
Naruto's eyes narrowed, not liking the way this man spoke of one of his mates.
Naruto-sama, come back to bed.
One of the girls called out.
Who was that? You had better not be doing vile perverted acts,
the tutor said furiously. Naruto seemed to study Ebisu's face for a moment.
Hey Ebisu, did you get a doctor to look at your nose yet?
Ebisu's anger turned into curiosity.
Why, what's wrong with my nose?
Slam.
Oh wow. My nose!
Naruto clapped his hands together, brushing off the imaginary dirt.
Now to find out what happened yesterday. Where is Naruto? Isn't he coming too?
Sakura asked, struggling to keep up with the weights they had to wear.
The council would not grant me permission to bring Naruto.
Kakashi's eye didn't stray from his book.
Why should the council care?
The Uchiha fiddled with the new sheath he had bought for a laster.
The council can be very difficult to deal with sometimes, Sasuke. But just because Naruto isn't coming doesn't mean you two will be allowed to slack off.
The two groaned, just thinking about the torture this guy called training made them ache all over. Thanks for listening. I do hope you enjoyed it. If you want the next part of this video, like, subscribe and comment down below and turn on the bell notification. And also check out other videos that I have created and enjoy. See you in the next video. Peace.